Hey guys, Silencio here. Welcome back to another episode of Kingdom Hearts 3. So in the last episode, we tried to enter back into the data realm where they can replicate Roxas's memories, I guess, or, you know, so that we can actually converse with him. But that didn't go too well, so let's head off and...
So, you think you can bring Roxas back?
Oh. Ansem! Xemnas!
Roxas should never have existed in the first place. What you seek is impossible.
Roxas does exist. His heart's inside my heart.
And in the unlikely event you did manage to separate the two, where is it you think you can put his heart?
Well, Roxas used to live in the other Twilight Town, right? So, I'm just gonna put him back there.
Do you even realize what you are saying? The other Twilight Town is just data.
A heart can live anywhere, even inside data. There are hearts all around us.
Ansem and Xemnas used to be part of the same person, right? But look, now they exist separately just fine. If they can do it, then I don't see any reason why you and Roxas can't find a way.
Oh, yeah!
He has a point.
You can adapt it, Goofy!
In that case, by all means.
Nothing would please us more than Roxas's return, of course.
You wish? He'll never answer to you again!
Still so blind. A nobody is what's left behind when one gives his heart to darkness. There is only one way to bring Roxas back, which is for you to give your heart up as well. Sora, have you finally decided to call upon the darkness?
What?
Go on then. The shadows are never out of reach. Now, set your heart free.
Wait!
Sora!
It's not darkness. Not if it helps him.
Now, this is pretty interesting. We are still quite early into the game, and we are finally meeting more powerful enemies like the Neo Shadows. Pretty interesting. Didn't expect them to appear so soon. Thanks, Donald. Not that I needed it, okay.
It's over.
Hey, Goofy leveled up.
I'm ready.
Best offense is a good defense. Oh man! Okay, I kind of overdid it for that one. Yeah.
Here we go.
So the form change is really useful if you need to counter react, I suppose. Okay, I need to heal again. But it seems like Donald is out of commission. Oh man! Okay, that was a bit unfortunate, but yeah, like I said, it's kind of interesting that we are suddenly meeting up with more powerful enemies at this point of time, with the Nobodies and of course the Neo Shadows. Do remind you guys, I'm playing on proud mode, so it's a bit more challenging than it should be, but nothing I can't handle, I suppose. Alright, let's do this again. Gotta be more careful with the HP and with my surroundings. Oh man. Oh, come on!
It's over.
Oh, dang, dang! Donald?
Thank you!
Thank you! So even without the customization of Donald being, I mean, like, you can't customize Donald to fit you as much anymore like Kingdom Hearts 1. I think they've kind of fixed the factor of how often Donald actually fits you. You still are able to customize Donald a bit, I suppose. Because at the beginning of this game, I did change certain things. Oh my goodness. Yeah. At the beginning, I did change certain things, and it kind of made Donald a bit more of a healer because he doesn't really spam all the offensive magic anymore. So, okay, I'm gonna have to learn how to attack and roll a bit. Oh, come on. There we go, Donald.
Here we go. Back off.
Didn't I stun you guys? Oh my goodness. Oh, this is new. So it's a literal Beyblade with a teacup. Fascinating. I think a lot of the rights all have to do with rotating. There we go. Third time's the charm.
Herc said, he said, with all my heart. Okay, then all my heart it is. I'm getting Roxas out. Are you with me? Donald? Goofy?
You betcha!
I don't know what Ansem and Xemnas want, but I think we better tell the others to watch out.
Okay then, let's head back to town.
Alright. Yeah, I would love to do that. Is it necessary to defeat all these heartless along the way? Considering that they are just wild spawns. But you know, it's Kingdom Hearts and it's a Japanese RPG, so grinding is part of the game.
It's over!
But we do need to level up just in case. Oh my goodness. After all, we are on proud mode. Oh wow. right. That was a nice one, but he didn't die. Oh my goodness. Oh shit! I'm gonna jump. Okay, let's create the path. Let's create the path we're going to ride on. And then we do the finisher. That's how you do it. There's really no need for this ride to be activated for too long as you create the path that you require. Yeah. You should be able to destroy most of the Heartless along the way. Okay, I don't really need to destroy them, so let's just move on. Sliding on gunk on the floor. What an ingenious idea. Oh, do we need a healing? There's just a few of you, so I guess I could do so. I wish I could choose the special commands to activate. I don't really want to use Blaster Blaze, I suppose. Oh, I can with L! L2! Oh my goodness, that makes gaming so much easier! Yeah! Are we done? Oh, cool! Alright, out we go!
Bless my bagpipes! It was you laddies who rescued my chef!
Ah, Scrooge!
Huh? Wait, didn't he sell ice cream in Hollow Bastion?
That's right! But Uncle Scrooge here is what you might call a world traveler!
Cool! How are you, Uncle Scrooge?
Oh, hello, Sora! You're looking hale and hearty! I heard you were on another grand adventure with these two. I hope Donald isn't making a menace of himself.
Why did you have to say that?
So, Uncle Scrooge, what's that you were saying about a chef?
Oh, right, right. The chef of me bistro here wanted to show you his appreciation. So, he baked this for you.
What is it?
Wow!
Cake! The whole cake? It's for us?
He's inside the hat.
Settle down. The chef wants you to know it's not a cake, but a tart of fruit.
He does?
Why keep it under my hat? May I introduce Little Chef?
Oh, it's you!
Uncle Scrooge, you opened the bistro in Twilight Town.
Aye. It all started a little while ago, when I was enjoying one of the best meals of my life. And when I asked to speak to the chef, I met this wee genius. As it turns out, he wanted to expand his culinary horizons. So I thought, that's an opportunity. And I financed the whole operation.
That's pretty generous of Scrooge.
Ooh! I think he wants to cook some more for you. Fetch some ingredients. Especially anything unusual.
That'll be fun! Kinda like a scavenger hunt.
And the more the better. The mark of a truly great chef is creating masterpieces out of anything. You can start right here in town.
We'll do anything to try more of Little Chef's food.
Yeah.
That tart sure did look scrumptiously delicious.
Okay, the ingredient hunt is on.
Well, we did get quite a few along the way. Alright, so at Little Chef's Bistro, you can transform the ingredients you've gathered into delicious meals. Eating the cuisine you prepare will grant you beneficial effects, like temporary stat increases. The recipes available at the bistro depend on the ingredients you get it, so be sure to scour each world you visit for the makings of new and powerful recipes. So, I guess this is Square Enix's way of making synthesizing a bit more interesting with the inclusion of Ratatouille into the series. So, pretty ingenious way of making things a bit more fun. Alright, so I guess we talk to Scrooge if you want to cook.
We'll be needing a wee bit more before cooking can begin.
Really? What do we need?
Guess we're still short. Let's keep searching.
Okay then. But where?
Let's struggle!
Whoa. Kinda miss collecting postcards and all that stuff. Okay, let's climb up this wall. So apparently the rooftop.
We can't leave. Little Chef still needs our help.
Fences can't be, you know, entered. Oh.
Little Chef needs more ingredients. We better keep an eye out.
You don't have to keep reminding me. Okay, let's go look around for more stuff. So I guess it's got to do with those Chinese food boxes that we saw. I suppose. Just look around. There we go. Chinese food boxes. Oh, come on! Caviar? Wow. Okay, we got some pretty fancy food stuff.
Hope we find some ingredients around here.
Okay, we're gonna wait for this thing to end again so we can take a photo of that Mickey mark that we missed in the last round. It's gonna take a while though. But let's just roam around first. Box here. There we go. Alright, so we've got the mark out.
Let's see. Got it.
Hey. Thank you. Although it was basically just me taking a photo of the screen. Not very photogenic, if you ask me. Okay, let's look around some more. I'm sure we can find more boxes that looks like they contain ingredients, I suppose.
I'm serious.
Nice moves!
So how many times can I perform this? And apparently it's...
And the crowd goes wild!
So every time I do it, I do get money. But how often I do it, that's another thing. Wow, we're getting a lot of expensive ingredients. Who keeps all this expensive stuff lying around them?
Well, I'm starting to get hungry.
You don't say. Okay, I can't get up here. Beatrix shot? I guess those are for the gummy ships. I don't suppose there are any ingredients here. Can we get more money from these people? Yeah!
We can't leave! Little Chef still needs our help!
Yeah, I know. It just happened that I'm just trying to enter an area. Butter! Okay, apparently we just got the last of the items.
Hey! Guys!
Huh? Oh. Hayner! Olette!
Hey, boss. Done with the posters.
Uh-huh? Hey! Good work, kids!
You guys work for Uncle Scrooge here at the Bistro?
Do we?
He gave us a short job putting up these special posters. Mr. McDuck's hosting an open-air film festival in the courtyard. Cool, huh?
Yeah, we were there.
Oh, Sora. Hold your phone up to the poster.
Oh, there's okay. A QR code.
There, you've just downloaded a promo game for the film. You can try it later.
Of course, laddie. Provide a bit of entertainment and then give folks a nice, cozy place to relax. Like my bistro here. They'll all be happy and hungry and eager to spend their money.
Uncle Scrooge.
He makes a good business sense.
Gosh, he sure is canny. I always wondered how he keeps customers coming into his businesses over and over.
Oh, yeah, I'm no business guy, but I sure wouldn't want to be one of Uncle Scrooge's competitors.
Seriously.
Oh, right. I need to warn you guys.
Why?
Well, those creepy crawly things might come back for more. So stay on your toes.
Sure, but don't we have you guys to take care of him for us?
You have to leave again?
Mm-hmm.
It's our job!
But we'll definitely be back.
When you gonna slow down?
Sorry. Just do me a favor.
Well, what is it? Don't make it too tough.
I know how Roxas feels to be lost, but Donald and Goofy, Kyrie, brought me back by wishing with all their hearts.
Mm-hmm.
So, I was hoping the three of you would do the same and wish for Roxas.
What? That's it? That's no favor. We'll all wish. I'm wishing.
Yeah. Me and Pence too.
Thanks.
Aren't you making it a little too obvious?
We were instructed to guide him.
Yes, just look at them. They wouldn't get far if we did not spell it out.
Huh. Fair enough. But let's not forget how many times Sora still managed to rain on our parade.
If he wavers from the path we lay, we destroy him.
But in that case, we'll have to find ourselves another vessel.
That is why we never have just one iron in the fire.
I wonder who they're talking about. Okay, classic Kingdom game. Oh yeah, so this is the QR code. Oh, cool. So, I don't know. Do we actually gain anything if we actually play these mini games again in Kingdom Hearts 3? There seems to be like more variations of the games. In Union Cross, there was only like 3 different versions. You had to play them to gain points, and of course, getting the points, you'll be able to unlock the Starlight Keyblade for this game. So yeah. Oh, who does the keychain belong to? Oh, that's interesting. Where did we get this keychain in the first place? Keyblade with an emphasis on magic form changes, double... What? Arrow guns? Yeah, so same as what we've seen in the figurines for the Kingdom Hearts key arts yeah, and all that stuff. Shooting star, Kibrick can be changed into a projectile weapon called the double arrow guns. While forward change, hold R2 to take aim and automatically fire a stream of shots towards your foes. Okay, that's pretty easy. I guess we can take a look at it. So, oh wait, I have to equip the keyblade. Select cuisine from the main menu to eat food and gain stat bonuses. To view your current bonuses, press triangle while the main menu is open. So I don't know, does the stat bonuses from cuisine actually become permanent or are they just temporary? So what's these? Okay, we lose strength. We lose 2 strength. But we boost in magic by 3. So that's not too bad, I suppose. If only we had the option like the Starlight and the Dawn to Dusk Keyblade, where you can just switch instead of equipping them. That would be more cool, especially with the Keyblades with the form changes that give you a different kind of set of abilities like the Guardian form and all that kind of stuff. So that would probably, hopefully, be something that Square Enix might implement in the future. Unison Fire, team up with Donald and to roast your foes. Fusion Spin, team up with Goofy, Donald, wreck havoc on surrounding foes. I need the recovery. Do they have that? No? Okay, and combo is definitely a must. I don't have enough for combo plus. Auto finish is definitely useful. MP haste is also useful. But I don't have cure right now, so that might not be too useful. I guess unison fire? Or maybe something a bit more neutral? Oh, I have to be near Goofy or near Donald. Okay. I suppose. Dang, this keyblade looks very, very nice. Really like the design of this one.
This might be a good spot to find some ingredients.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so where are we supposed to go? Are we supposed to go out of this world? I suppose so. We did say we were gonna leave and then come back again another time.
I'm sorry I left without saying goodbye. Did Master Yensid tell you? I'm training to become a Keyblade wielder, like you. That's right. No more waiting for you to come back from your adventures.
Does Kari sound different?
I want to get out there and do my part to help. Merlin has used his magic to bring us to a place where time doesn't matter. We can take as long as we need to complete our training. He's an amazing wizard. Oh, and by us, I mean me and Lee. He's really sorry for all the trouble he caused. I told him it's fine, but he won't stop apologizing. I'll admit, I was a little scared of him at first, but I've gotten to know him better. All he ever wanted was to help his friend. Honestly, it's hard not to like him. Every now and then, I catch him staring at me. When I ask what's wrong, he says, "I'm not sure. I think I'm forgetting something. Don't know what. Sora, I think it may have something to do with you. Your journey is all about helping people. Some that you've never met before, and some like Lee that you have. They're all counting on you. It won't be easy, but I hope you'll remain the happy and cheerful Sora I know. There's no heart your smile can't reach."
Oh, she's still wearing her Kingdom Hearts 2 costume.
What's wrong?
Huh? Nothing. Sorry.
Lee.
What? I am.
I think we misses Shion. After all, Shion does look like Kairi.
To even Sora. Though
she is Sora's nobody as well. I don't know. That makes no sense, but yeah.
But I won't send it. It's more for me.
Ask Merlin. He'll deliver it for you.
Yeah. But it's okay. I just like talking to Sora. Even if it's on paper.
Huh. Okay. Oh.
Hmm?
Here.
Oh my god, he had those in his pockets without wrappers?
Yeah, I asked Merlin to pick these up. You know, we did both summon Keyblades. Gotta celebrate.
That's kind of disgusting.
You're sweet, Lee.
And disgusting.
Nah.
No, don't eat it, Kairi. Oh my goodness.
What?
Nothing. I just...
You're trying to remember what you forgot?
Well, I, yeah. Yeah.
I never really noticed Kairi's Kingdom Hearts 2 costume.
You ready?
Does have a bit of design on Namine's dress in it.
Don't hold back, Lee. Promise?
Oh. Yeah, he misses Shion. See, I knew it.
Huh? Are you okay? Lee!
Yeah. Sorry.
You're crying. What's wrong?
Something in my eyes.
Lee.
I'm gonna go. Sorry.
Okay, but stop apologizing.
Fine. On one condition.
What?
Call me Axel from now on. Got it? Memorized?
Yeah. Okay, Axel.
Does he actually like the name Axel? Hey, you forgot your popsicle. So I guess we no longer have to call him Lee. Or is that just Kairi?
So this is the place.
Where Aqua fell into the realm of darkness after she dove in to save Terra.
Yeah. She said he was acting strange.
Strange how, exactly?
She sensed darkness in him. And they ended up getting into a big fight.
Right. And in the aftermath, the two of them disappeared. Around the same time, the guards found a stranger with white hair lying unconscious here in the square. A man calling himself Xehanort.
Ansem the Wise took the stranger in, but that was a mistake. Xehanort betrayed his master, stole his research, and along with his fellow apprentices, separated his heart from his body. Xehanort's heart took his master's name, Ansem, and traveled to the past to give his younger self instructions. He even briefly had control of you. His empty body stayed in the present, took the name Xemnas, and founded Organization 13. Their goal was to prepare 13 vessels for Xehanort's heart.
Until we put an end to the organization. But all the while, young Xehanort had been visiting the future to choose 13 vessels of his own. Hearts with strong enough ties to him to begin a new organization. The real Organization 13. And now they're looking for a fight with us. But what happened to Terra? I thought you said that Aqua saved him.
Yep, She did. The problem is we didn't notice. You remember the end of the Mark of Mastery exam? When Master Xehanort made his grand return? That's the Xehanort I remember. He was already a pretty old man then. But how do you explain Ansem and Xemnas, his heartless, and his nobody? Isn't it strange how young they look? Why aren't they old men? It's because Xehanort was using a different body when the split happened. That face from the portrait I mentioned? It wasn't just some stranger that Ansem the Wise took under his wing. It was the young man whose body Master Xehanort possessed.
No way! That was Terra? Master Xehanort was using Terra?
Yep. Master Xehanort told us another on our list belonged to him. He was talking about Terra. Turns out, Aqua saved more than just her friend that day.
Okay. But Master Xehanort is an old man again now. Where did Terra's body go?
It's 'cause Master Xehanort's collecting vessels! He claimed to have 2 of our 7 lights. We got Sora back, but Terra must still be on Xehanort's side.
He's with Organization 13? We should warn Sora.
Yep! And Merlin too!
Yeah.
Wow, we just got a brief history of Kingdom Hearts in one short clip. Whew! That was pretty exciting.
I got a tip for you!
What? Okay. From here, you can voyage to new worlds on your gummy ship. Or if you're feeling creative, you can use the gummy editor to create your own custom ship. Pathways to new worlds are open. To visit a new world, you have to reach it on your gummy ship. Once you've reached the world, you'll be able to walk back and forth anytime. Okay, so it's pretty much like the old games. So I guess we have to do the gummy ship travel thing for the first time when exploring new worlds. So that's not too bad. Bistro has been unlocked. You can now visit Little Chef's Bistro from right here on the world map. Don't forget that you won't be able to cook unless you have enough ingredients. Alright. Gummy shop. I don't know, let's take a look at the gummy shop first. Do they have recipes? I'm still very intrigued with this. So they do have a recipe here. Falcon. Okay, no, I don't think we need to change anything now. Let's.
I got a tip for you.
Okay, where are we heading to? No. Oh. So we've unlocked one of the 3 treasure spheres already. I guess we could unlock another one. Waypoint, Kingdom of Corona. Isn't that? Yeah, it's Tango's universe. Okay, I guess this is where we're going. Yeah. Let's go! Oh boy, so it's this way. It's nice that they don't start you off with the gummy ship moving, so you can actually decide on your own time. So I guess they really improved the gameplay for the gummy ship, which I really, really, really like this new adjustment. Okay, I guess we could go this way. Oh, it's the boost. Okay. Oh, I'm still not used to the controls! Oh my goodness, I really, really need to get used to the controls. Oh! Which way? It's quite a distance though. I wonder if there's like a physical map on the entire galaxy for gummy ship travel. Can you imagine mapping this entire thing out? Oh, I just realized there's a level for the gummy ship. Oh, that's cool. Wait, where is this? Is this the Toy Story world? Oh, I think we went to the wrong world. I guess that's fine. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. This is gonna take a while because the gummy ship isn't really upgraded, so this is just horrendous. I wonder how long it'll take.
A few moments later.
Yeah, this is taking really— oh wow, I actually cheated it, okay. I was just going to say that it's gonna take really long again. Okay, so Toy Story World. It's definitely not the world we're supposed to go. I don't know. Did I mark this world? Or is the yellow one actually the one that we're supposed to go to? This is so confusing. What's this? Constellations. During your voyages, you will discover constellations, photographing constellations. Press what to bring out the camera. Okay.
Let's see.
Where? That thing? I don't see any constellations. Let's head over here first and take a look. Is this the one?
Let's see.
No? Okay, that's strange. Alright, let's just head over to the yellow marker. Alright, we are finally here. Kind of a long detour. Because I didn't know that the yellow marker was the one that we're supposed to go to instead of the green one. Oh well. Mistakes were learned.
Why can't I go outside?
The outside world is a dangerous place. You must stay here where you're safe. Do you understand, Flower?
Those lights appear every year on my birthday. Only on my birthday. And I can't help but feel like they're meant for me. I need to see them, and not just from my window, in person. I have to know what they are.
Thank you.
It sure is a pretty day.
Yeah, the weather is great. It'd be perfect for a picnic.
Why do you think we came here?
Got me, Donald.
We'll figure it out as we go.
Okay.
I'm sure we were brought to this world for some good reason, but can't we sweat it later?
Fine with me. As long as there's no harvest.
Make way! Make way! Make way!
Heartless! You see, soon as you mention them, they show up.
There goes our picnic.
I didn't do it.
It's okay. Let's send these guys packing.
Say, since you three seem to know what you're doing, mind if I leave this one to you?
Yep. We'll take care of them. Go on, skedaddle.
You have my thanks. Whew. The horse was enough. Don't need any monsters on my trail.
What's enough?
Oh, nothing. Name's Flynn, Flynn Rider. Oh, watch out, they look mad.
Slowly.
Out of here!
All right, let's get to it. New friends to play with, I suppose. What? Oh, the arrow. Oh, man. Let's shoot a bang bang! Woo! Woo! Rapid fire! Woo! Alright! What is this? Oh man, I'm supposed to go far away! Okay, that was not well done. Yeah. Oh, we're learning. Alright, things are a lot easier to play with now thanks to the learning of the L2 button. Where are you going? Come here and get shot. Whoa! Hello! Okay, let's change this. Oh! No, I was going to change my weapon to the rocket launcher. God dang it! It's okay, we are still shooting. Okay, we're gonna finish it now. Boom! Nice! So apparently the
Come on!
Apparently the tree dropped more heartless, I don't know. Did shooting the tree not help at all?
Huh? Where'd Flynn go?
He's skedaddled.
That indeed
he did. I think I saw him go that away.
Huh? But that away is just a dead end.
How would you know?
Yeah, that's puzzling.
I mean, he just came to this world.
I say we investigate.
Nosy, aren't we? Right.
Graham, where are you?
Let's get the map.
Flynn? That was close.
Alright, let's not miss out on certain things. Maybe like ingredients and all the chests available. Seems like there's nothing here. Okay.
Hope we find some ingredients around
butterflies.
Here.
We just did. Bay leaf? Can we cook butterflies? Oh, there's caviar.
I put it up top this way.
Well, at least he got away safe, right?
Huh? Hey, now Sora's gone too.
This way, guys. It's a secret passage. Oh.
How you doing? The name's Flynn Rider. How's your day going? Huh?
Who else knows my location, Flynn Rider?
All right, hang on, Blondie.
Rapunzel.
Gesundheit. Here's the deal. I was in a situation gallivanting through the forest when I stumbled upon a... Oh? Oh, no, no. No, 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 no. Where is my satchel?
I've hidden it. Somewhere you'll never find it. So, what do you want with my hair? To cut it?
Huh?
Sell it?
No!
Wait, you don't want my hair?
Why on earth would I want your hair? Look, I was being chased, I saw a tower, I climbed it, okay? End of story.
Hmm?
Huh?
Okay, Flynn Rider. I'm prepared to offer you a deal.
A deal?
Look this way. Do you know what these are?
You mean the lantern thing they do for the princess?
Lanterns? I knew they weren't stars. Well, tomorrow evening, they will light the night sky with these lanterns. You will act as my guide. Take me to these lanterns and return me home safely. Then, and only then, will I return your satchel to you. That is my deal.
Yeah, no can do. Unfortunately, the kingdom and I aren't exactly simpatico at the moment, so I won't be taking you anywhere.
Pascal is so cute.
Something brought you here. Flynn Rider. Call it what you will, fate, destiny. So I have made the decision to trust you.
A horrible decision, really.
I am serious.
Oh! Let me get this straight. I take you to see the lanterns, bring you back home, then you give me back my satchel?
I promise. And when I promise something, I never, ever break that promise. Ever.
Oh, what to do? I cannot let her find that tiara. Okay, just think. I need the satchel, and Blondie has it. There might be more monsters out there. I've got it! The three guys in the funny outfits. They look tough enough to come in handy. All right, fine. I'll take you. But on one condition. My three sidekicks come along.
Is it me or is Rapunzel's hair not very detailed on the standard PlayStation 4? Maybe the Pro might look a bit more detailed.
Look at that! A tower! Let's check it out!
And we walk right into being his lackeys. Hey, Mungo! Hello, dear boy. So cute. What's this? Koopa coins. If you're holding a Koopa coin, when Sora runs out of HP, the power of the Moogles will restore Sora from defeat. Oh! So it's a continue? Wow! You can buy one Koopa coin at a time at the Moogle shop. The coin will be spent automatically when it is needed. Oh, 400. So I guess it's one of those revive abilities, but you know, the more you use it, I guess the item might become more expensive in the future, I suppose. So that's my speculation. Oh, he sells ingredients. Wow. No wait, these are not ingredients, these are cooked food. Huh. Oh, this is a funky looking shield. Oh, he does sell ingredients, okay. We don't have black truffle. And it's a bit pricey though. Do we need this? Power ring that gives AP. Yeah, we do need AP though. I guess we could buy one of these. I guess we could have Donald equipped with this as well. Okay, I think we're good.
There's a mailbox in Twilight Town.
What?
Let's send this off next time we're in Twilight Town.
Oh, cool. They brought back the postcards.
Wonder who.
Alright, so we're gonna equip all the stuff we just got. So I do want to have my power ring. I guess we can have potions. Magic ring. Goofy always needs AP though, so. Do we have armor? Oh, we do. Okay. Let's take a look at the abilities again. We do have two abilities. Don't think we can use it for anything. We're short. Okay, let's take a look at Donald. Donald has 3 MP haste. I think he needs MP haste more. Goofy, luck strike. Increase how often enemies drop items. Oh, that's pretty useful. Okay. I think we're good to go.
Tower here.
Let's go find out.
Alright, this is a pretty big area. It does look like the map in Union Cross, though. Get him up.
Yeah.
Alright, let's create the path. Alright, make sure we cover all areas. And let's do the finishing. Hopefully we got everyone. Apparently we missed one. Well, there's no one else to use it on. She's so paranoid.
It's so soft. I'm free. I'm really free.
Flynn, good to see you in one piece.
Huh? Guys, you're here and just in time.
Who's she?
That would be Rapunzel. Something tells me this could be her first time outdoors. Give her a few minutes to get used to it.
First time ever?
I can't believe I did this!
I can't believe I did this.
I can't believe I did this!
Mother would be so furious if she knew I disobeyed her and left the tower. But that's okay, I mean, what she doesn't know won't kill her. Right? No. Oh my gosh, this would kill her.
This is so fun!
I'm a horrible daughter.
It's like a replicate of the entire movie.
I am never going back! I am a despicable human being.
Oh, this is so fun.
Ever!
I notice you seem a little at war with yourself here.
A little more than a little?
More not a lot.
Yeah.
Stop right there! Who are you?
Oh!
I told you before, my sidekicks.
Sidekicks?
May I introduce...
My name's Sora.
Donald!
And I'm Goofy. Pleasure, ma'am.
Sora, Donald, and Goofy. It's nice to meet you, too. I'm Rapunzel.
Yep, my sidekicks. Hey.
Since when is that?
Look, she really wants to see the lantern show tomorrow night. Now, I'm a nice guy, so I've decided to help her. Only problem is those monsters might show up again. I can get her to the kingdom, but you guys are clearly more cut out for combat.
That's 'cause we're heroes!
Uh-huh.
And we're heartless experts.
Yeah, yeah!
Just leave it to us.
Done.
Good job, Nomura.
Yeah, her heart's pulling her all kinds of ways.
Everything fits so nicely.
The outside world must seem so big and scary. I know how she feels. Lucky for me, you two came along at just the right time. And the rest has been unforgettable.
Yeah, they literally fell on you, so...
Yep. Unforgettable. Just like your face.
Oh,
Come on, Mal.
All for one, and one for all.
All right, let's go. That's a lot of party members.
Look, the flowers are growing on top of the water.
Yeah. Wait, can talk to Donald?
Rapunzel has a great smile.
I agree. She's probably my favorite princess.
Rapunzel must be pretty excited if this is really her first time outside the tower.
Ha! Oh, sorry, Goofy.
How did I get myself into this?
Well, you literally climbed into it. Alright, so where do we move off to? Probably the prettiest world we've traveled to so far. Everything's so green.
The outside world is even better than I dreamed.
Well, you're not all the way outside yet, lady. Well, this is the beginning part. So, where are we heading to? Is there a way to expand the map? Okay, we are back here.
What will Mother think?
What's this? Oh, it's a poster of him! Don't want her to see that now. Oh, what's that? Oh, it's another of those heartless.
Oh. Look! What is that? It's so fluffy! Huh.
Heartless! Rapunzel, take cover!
Huh? All right, I hate to say it, but I'm letting you out of this deal.
What?
It's way too scary out here. Let's just turn around and take you home.
No, I am seeing those lanterns.
Oh, come on!
Hey, she's gonna fight!
Rapunzel?
It's okay. I'm not afraid to face them.
Here we go!
Be careful, Rapunzel!
I will!
Yeah. Oh, cool! They snapped!
Look! They made a tower!
Here we go!
Oh my! That thing shoots! Here we go, guys. Keep firing away. Kind of forgotten that we have Lockshot. Since we have all these abilities now. Lockshot is not as impressive as it used to be. Boom! Nice! There's so many of them. Ooh! You don't really need to see the lanterns, we have all the festivities right here. Alright, let's do this! Boom! Woo! That is so satisfying! Whoa! The Panzo! You have it, girl! Alright, we're almost done! The last one. All right, just for the sake of it. Apparently, I didn't have to. Wait. What? Come on. Okay, here we go. How many of them are there? One moment, the color of Sora kind of looked like Roxas. Okay, so this form change is pretty easy. You just have to do an attack and get further away, and then just go into the barrage mode. Oh no!
Rapunzel? Rapunzel!
Wow, this is animated really nicely.
Someone?
Who's there?
She's such a precious gift. Allow me to assist you in getting her back.
Alright guys, we're gonna end the episode here. It's been an awesome adventure. Loving this current world. It is so pretty. Look at all the little flowers. And yes, like I said earlier, Rapunzel is probably my most favorite princess of heart as of now. And yeah, things are looking a lot brighter at this part of the story. We do have a lot of the Disney aspects really brought into the Kingdom Hearts world very well. Everything feels so natural, like it fitted perfectly as if it belonged together. Once again, kudos to Nomura on doing this project so well. Hopefully you guys as excited as I am.
How wonderful this is.
Oh my goodness, yes, I can't believe it too that I'm stuttering. So guys, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next adventure of Kingdom Hearts 3. Until then, bye!